watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice.
So today's video is going to be a DIY holiday treat, and I am so excited. I first have the holiday popcorn little Chex Mix. I'm not even sure what to call this, but it has like Oreos and melted chocolate and popcorn, and it's the most amazing thing ever. Like, let me tell you, this is actually so addicting. I have these adorable candy cane fudge pops, and they're so good. I want to like stop the video so I can eat this because it's actually amazing. And then I have the reindeer cupcakes, and like, look at this. Tell me this is not the most adorable little cupcake you've ever seen in your life, because it's the most adorable cupcake I've ever seen in my life. And I also have candy cane marshmallow pop things. Not really sure what to call them, but I left those downstairs. So if you guys want to see my DIY holiday treats, then stay tuned and keep on watching.
So we're first going to be starting off with the holiday popcorn, and the things you'll need are popcorn, and I recommend one with low butter, some candy cane kisses, and some winter Oreos. After you heat up your popcorn, you're going to want to take a cooking pan and just lay some aluminum foil over it just so you can spill out your popcorn on it. And I used about half a bag of popcorn, so you guys may use more or less, it depends on how much you're making. And then you're gonna take about 5 or 6 of your Oreos, I think I used about 6 of them, and then you're gonna crush them up in a plastic baggie. And now you're just going to layer the Oreos all over the popcorn, and you're going to mix it in, so be sure you like stir it and stuff just so it's completely mixed in. And then you're going to start opening up your candy cane kisses and put them into a cup, preferably one that can be microwaved. And after you guys open up all of your candy cane kisses, you're just going to microwave it. I was using 30 second intervals, so I would check on it, stir it, and then put it in again until it was completely melted. And then after it's completely melted, you're just gonna start spilling it over your popcorn. You don't have to do this neatly, but be sure you stir it in just so it completely coats all of the popcorn. And this is so, so good. I love this popcorn. So I literally just soaked all the popcorn with the chocolate. And after I did that, I just poured it into a bowl and I let it sit for about an hour just so the chocolate hardened up. The next treat I'm going to be doing today is the candy cane lollipops, and I love these. And the first thing you're going to need is some white chocolate, some mini candy canes, and lollipop sticks. It's a super, super simple DIY, and I think you guys will love this one. So the first thing I did was just lined my cooking pan with aluminum foil once again, and then I laid out my candy canes in shapes of hearts because it's super adorable. And then after I did that, I just took my lollipop sticks and I laid it in between the two candy canes. Couples holding hands, places don't go. After I finished lining up the candy canes and the lollipop sticks, I began to cut up my white chocolate. And if you guys would prefer, you could use milk chocolate, but I just prefer white chocolate. And then I crushed up some candy canes just so I could sprinkle it over the chocolate after it was melted. And so whenever it melted, all you do is take a spoon and pour the chocolate into the heart. It's so, so simple. And make sure you get a little bit over the lollipop stick just so the lollipop stick doesn't like fall off, because then it wouldn't be a lollipop. So just make sure you pour it over a tiny bit so when it hardens, it will be stuck to the chocolate. And this is optional, but I just decided to sprinkle over some crushed candy canes, and then after that I put it in the refrigerator for an hour just so the chocolate could harden. This next DIY is actually my favorite, and it's reindeer cupcakes. These are so cute, guys. The things you'll need are vanilla wafers, some red and white M&Ms, black icing, and pretzels. And then you'll also need some chocolate frosting and cupcakes. I just chose chocolate cupcakes because they're my favorite. After I finished lining my cupcake pan, I began to make my cupcakes. So I just combined all of the ingredients together, and I didn't go in depth on this because I think we all know how to make cupcakes, and if we don't, it has ingredients on the back, so I'm not going to go into detail on that. Why don't you let me stop by? The clock is ticking, running out of time, so we should party. After my cupcakes were done baking, I just frosted them, and I chose chocolate frosting because reindeers are brown, so it made the most sense. But if you don't want to use chocolate frosting, you can easily change it. If you want it all, you know that I'm the girl that you should call. After you finish frosting the cupcakes, you get to begin decorating them, which is the fun part because it's what makes the whole entire thing. So the pretzels were the antlers, and then I used the white M&Ms as the eyes, of course. And then the vanilla wafers were just the mouth portion of the reindeer. And then I took a red M&M to use as the nose. And these were kind of like Rudolph inspired. They're super, super cute. Now for the marshmallow dippers. If you guys like marshmallows, you will love this. So the things you need is melted chocolate. I used milk chocolate and white chocolate, and you'll also need candy canes and of course marshmallows, because it wouldn't be complete without marshmallows. And so I first started off by melting the chocolates in the microwave. You're going to want to take your candy canes and just stab the marshmallows. That's literally the best way to explain it. And then you're just going to dip the marshmallows into the chocolate. And then after you dip it, right away you're going to want to sprinkle the candy canes over it just so it doesn't harden, because it does harden very fast.
Thank you so much for watching my DIY holiday treats. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thumbs it up if you guys love DIYs, and maybe I'll do another one for the holiday season. And comment down below what your favorite DIY in this video was. Wow, I've said DIY so many times, my god. Oh yeah, I'm doing Vlogmas on my vlog channel, so go subscribe down below. You guys can see what I've been doing every single day. I love you guys, bye.